It's a 5-horsepower, 184T frame NEMA motor. It's supposed to be pulling about 14 amps at 230 volts, 1725 RPMs. This is a three-phase motor. I have a single-phase supply here at my garage. As you can see, the white wire is not hooked up. We are just using the black and red wire. Green wire is a ground wire. I got it hooked up to a starter box, basically, that takes this three-phase motor and starts it. Once it starts the three-phase motor, you can hook up other motors in succession. That's what this other mess is over here on the other side. I'll make a second video explaining how to hook all of that good stuff up. But basically, right now, this is just an instructional video of how you would hook this thing up once you get it. Alright, so basically, I'm going to send it to you with just these three wires exposed. This will be the input side of it. For clarification, this is a 20 amp plug that I'm putting on here for demonstration purposes. You might want to do however you're going to do it on this end of the motor. This is the actual functioning RPC, as it's known, a rotary phase converter. This idling by itself, I was measuring about 14 amps here on a single phase supply. And even with these other motors hooked up to it, I got a maximum of 22 amps. So this thing is quite efficient for running a three-phase motor on single-phase supply. As far as this video is concerned, all you gotta really worry about is getting your ground wire correct. This plug here is a NEMA 20-amp plug. You'll see one leg looks a little bit different. It has a little tip that points to the out, which denotes it's a 20-amp NEMA plug. You may want to replace that with whatever you're going to run this thing on the other side. If you're going to run a bus bar or another distribution, or if you, for whatever reason, wanted to make a multiple tap plug or whatever, there is that function. And by all means, you can holler at me at any time, and we'll get you working one way or the other. But I can demonstrate right this second that this thing will work. I'll go ahead and plug it in. Okay, we're live now. So, just to be clear here, on our red wire, we have one leg of the single phase. On the black wire, we have the second leg of the single phase wiring. We have a green wire here, which is the ground wire. This is supplying single phase power to this converter box, and all this converter box does is basically get this motor started. Once this motor gets started, the box really is out of the circuit, and the 5-horsepower motor becomes an auto generator, which produces a signal that three-phase motors can use, and it works quite well, actually. You don't lose the power that you would if you were to use a static converter. That is the bonus about this. But what is nice is you can hook up multiple motors to it. We'll go ahead and start it. So I have a big enough capacitor in this thing where it does not mess around. It starts right away and gets out of the circuit. The capacitor, just used just for a second, and the motor turns. And now this here, if you're to measure it on the plug, we're going to get a three-phase output of it. You'll notice that one of the outputs will be slightly lower than the other, but it's within the specified the tolerances of loss. And as long as you're not hooking it up to super sensitive equipment or whatever, the machines will really no difference. The more machines that you do run on this field, though, it does become stronger on the third leg, just for opposition. So, in case of power failure or of any other thing, you can shut that thing off just like that. And what is nice about it is this will not restart until an operator tells it to. It won't restart on its own if there's a power outage, if something should happen where it's running and you guys lose power or whatever. It's a safety feature. That's probably enough for this video. We'll explain the hookup of the other mess here on another one. But this is for you, Mike. Aloha.